Hi, my name is Manos Porsen and I will present to you Peter the Great. The question we are facing today is if Peter deserves the name the Great. Before we come to this conclusion, we have to see his background. So we will see his characteristics, his vision and his actions. Peter was born in Moscow, Russia in 1672. Later on, he became very violent and he was very cruel. He even put his own son in prison. In 1682, Peter became the king of Russia. At that time, he had many visions. One of his visions was that Russia's future lay towards Europe. The second vision was to end Russia's landlocked situation. Following his second vision first, he had to make stronger his army, because in 1700 until 1721, he had wars with Sweden and Russia won. By winning this war, he solved his landlocked situation because he got land that had access to the Baltic Sea. Later, he followed his first vision. He made a new city, St. Petersburg, and he changed the capital of Russia from Moscow to St. Petersburg. Then, he forced the nobles to wear European clothes and also to shave their long beards. He allowed women to go outside their houses. He also made great changes in trade, finance, and industry. Also, he put taxes on everything so that he can pay his army and to take care of it. He had complete control and he had control of the Orthodox Church. The nobles were getting their privilege not because of their family status, but on their participation in the government. I believe that Peter deserves the name the Great, even if he didn't succeed to get help by the European countries to destroy the Turks. But instead, he made Russia one of the greatest countries in Europe.
Created using Powtoon.